Alright, so let's look at this problem. We've got this frame that supports this distributed load, and I want to determine the state of stress at point E. What is the normal stress at E? What is the shear stress at E? So E is, I gotta know two things. I gotta know where to cut it. So E is right here, so I need to cut it right here. And I need to know where on that cross section I'm at. The middle, at the top, at the bottom. So here, I'm towards the bottom, 20 millimeters from the bottom. But I need to cut it and solve for N, V, and M. And then think about the three stresses that N, V, and M cause. And I can combine the N over A with MY over I. Before I cut it, though, so my first instinct is to cut it and solve for the N, V, and M, but I need to do some statics. Got to be able to do this and do it pretty quickly and easily. I need to solve for the AX and the AY. Also right here, what is that? Remember that from statics? Pinned and pinned, that's a two-force member. So this F, BC right here at 3, 4, 5. So anyway, before I cut it, let me look at my statics and sum the forces in X equals zero, sum the forces Y equals zero, sum the moments equals zero. And actually, the more comfortable you are at those, the more you probably know that, hey, summing the moments might be a good place to start. So summing the moments about A, AX goes straight through it, AY goes straight through it. This is just a recap from statics. And since we have the time, I'm going to do this for make sure you understand how to do this, right? Summing the moments about A, AX goes straight through it, AY goes straight through it. I can replace this. I don't know if you've done many triangular loads like this, but I can place this triangular load at the middle, at the centroid of that triangle, and it is 1/2 base times height. So this would be a 12 kilonewton force right there. So I've got 12 kilonewtons acting 3 meters away, creating a negative moment. But then I've got the 3/5 component of FBC acting 6 meters away, creating a positive moment. So I would get FBC is 10 kilonewtons. Then summing the forces in X, AX minus, let's see, the 4/5 component, and of course this is 10 right here, let me plug that in, 10 equals 0, so I would get AX 8 kilonewtons, and summing the forces in Y, AY minus 12, and the 3/5 component of 10, set that equal to 0, and get AY is 6 kilonewtons. So, all right, had to do that before I cut it right here and solve for N, V, and M. I know that AY is 6, AX is 8, and I still have a portion of this distributed load that has a height of, so if I'm cutting it right here, it goes all the way to a height of 4. This is halfway. You look at similar triangles, but it's halfway. You can see it goes to a height of 2. And so if it goes to a height of 2, then I can replace this with a one force that is acting at 1 from here, 0.5 from here, and a magnitude of 1/2 base times height. 1.5 kilonewtons right there. Okay? All right, and so now I can sum the forces in X, N, and 8. So I've got N is negative 8 kilonewtons. What's that negative mean? We're using the positive sign convention. I drew it in tension. That negative means it is in compression. I'll think about that moving forward. So that N is negative 8. Summing the forces in Y, I've got 6 minus 1.5 minus V, and I would get V is equal to 4.5 kilonewtons. And then summing the moments, I like to sum the moments about the cut. Let me give myself some more room. Summing the moments about the cut, I've got M, positive, positive is counterclockwise. In goes straight through the cut. V goes straight through the cut. This 8 goes through the middle of the cut. But the 6 is acting 1.5 away, creating a negative moment. But the 1.5 is acting 0.5 away, creating a positive moment. Set those equal to 0. I've got an M of positive 8.25 kilonewton meters. What does that positive mean? That positive means it is the way that I drew it. I drew it in the positive sign convention, and positive moments are like a smiley face. If this was a pool noodle, I would really exaggerate, and we could really bend that pool noodle upwards. Okay, so now I've got my N, V, and M. Let me think about the stress that the N causes, the stress that the V causes, the stress that the M causes, and I can combine the normal stresses due to normal force and the normal stress due to the bending moment. So let's look at this stress of N over A. So this would be 8 kilonewtons. I would prefer 8,000 newtons. And the area, well, what's just the area of that rectangle? 50 by 100. 50 millimeters by 100 millimeters. And see why I change it to newtons. Newtons over millimeters squared would be MPa. This would be 1.6 MPa. Okay, but positive or negative? I had a negative right there. Probably should have had a negative right here. This is negative. This is compression. This is compression. Now, I actually don't like you to tell me negative and compression. So either just put negative 1.6 MPa or just tell me it's in compression. I'm not sure which one I really want to do. So negative 1.6 MPa, that's the normal stress caused by this normal force N right here. Okay, the tau VQ over IT, the V 4.5, I'm going to do 4,500 so that I'm in newtons and millimeters squared. The Q, all right, have you, hopefully haven't already forgotten how to find the Q. Let's find the Q for point E right here. Q is the Y bar prime A prime, and I'm going to come back to Y bar prime. A prime is the easiest. It is just the area below. Why below? Because I'm below the neutral axis. It's the area away from E, and so that would be that rectangle right there, which would be a 50 by 20 rectangle, 50 by 20. And then the Y bar prime is the distance from the neutral axis, not just to point E, but to the centroid of A prime. And so this would be, let me think about, look at this. I would go 30 millimeters just to get to point E, but then I need to go another halfway, another 10. So I would be going, all right, let's check this, 40 millimeters. 40 would be the Y bar prime. Very important. This was an easy one. Very important that you can find that Q for the VQ over IT. So this is going to be 40 millimeters, and the area was 20 millimeters by 50 millimeters right there. Divided by I, the I, this was just a plain old rectangle. 1/12 B, 50 H, the total H cubed, and then the thickness would be this 50 millimeters right here. I think the units do work out. I'm left with newtons divided by millimeters squared, and newtons divided by millimeters squared is MPa. And I've got a pretty large 864 MPa right here. 864 megapascals right there. All right, and now the bending stress caused by the MY over I. So the MY over I, the M is 8.25. Ooh, I like newtons, and I like millimeters. I'll take care of this in just a minute. 8.25 kilonewton meters times the Y. Now, don't overthink this Y. This Y is different from, this is the Y bar prime. The Y for the MY over I, the Y is just the distance to the point. The distance from the neutral axis to point E. This was symmetric, so neutral axis obviously right there. Distance to point E, that is just 30, different from the Y bar prime of 40. So this is 30 millimeters. I is 1/12 50, 100 cubed. All right, so I prefer newtons. I know that newtons divided by millimeters squared is MPa. And so to get rid of that kilonewtons, multiply it times 1,000. But then to get rid of that meters, change it to millimeters, multiply it times 1,000 again. Then I've gotten rid of the kilonewtons, gotten rid of the meters. I'm left with newtons, 4 millimeters on the bottom, 2 millimeters on the top. So newtons per millimeter squared. That would be, let me look one page over, 59.4 MPa. All right, but positive or negative? But positive or negative, 59.4 MPa. I need to know, because that one was a negative. That one was in compression up there. The normal force due to the normal stress due to the normal force was in compression. Should this be positive or negative? Well, this was a positive moment. This was a positive moment that creates a smiley face. If we was really to exaggerate the bend of this beam, it would look like a smiley face. And so think about a pool noodle and think about that smiley face. And think about if you kind of put your finger on top of that pool noodle, if you put your finger on the top of the pool noodle, it would get compressed, it would get pinched, right? And so the top of a positive moment would be compression. We're looking at point E, which is the bottom of a positive moment. And the bottom of a positive moment would be tension, And so this would be positive. If you don't like visualizing it yourself, then this is what you need to do. You need to say that, use the book's definition of negative MY over I. So you've got a negative right here. This is a positive moment. But this is a negative y. This is a negative y because it's below the neutral axis. And so negative, negative, we got two negatives, turns out to be a positive. Okay, so let's answer the question. We've got to combine this correctly. Well, let's answer the question. The sigma at this point would be a positive 59.4 and a negative 1.6. So at point E, if I cut it right there at point A, E, and if I'm looking right here on the cross section, I would have a shear stress 57.8 MPa in tension, and I would have a tau of 864 MPa. You don't really have to give it a positive or negative. It's the same direction as the V. V was written in positive sign convention, and so it is. Your shear stress is always the same direction as your shear force. And so there we go. That is the state of stress at point E. This is for a 2D problem. So take a step back, you know, take your breath and look at what we did. Had to use statics to find AX and AY. I had to cut it and solve for NV and M. I looked at the three stresses that NV and M cause, and I combined the N over A stress with the MY over I stress, but very careful with my positives and negatives. So that's the state of stress for 2D problems. So you can look ahead. I'm going to make it more complicated and move on to 3D problems.